Welcome back. Carbon monoxide from smoke belching vehicles are hazardous to human health, and unless you suit up in a biohazard outfit, there's no way of avoiding it on Metro Manila streets. Now, this is why a leading paint manufacturer has developed a very unlikely weapon to combat air pollution.
Air pollution smells nasty and is really bad for the environment.
The World Health Organization reports about 3 million people are killed worldwide by air pollution from vehicles and industrial emissions annually. In Metro Manila alone, it is said that one of every 8 premature deaths is caused by air pollution, one of the dangerous and highly reactive gases generated from vehicle emissions is nitrogen oxides, or NOx. In large and bustling cities like Manila, the amount of NOx emitted into the atmosphere can be quite significant. But believe it or not, a paint has been developed to combat toxic emissions. And what it does for the environment is not like watching paint dry. Boysen's NOx out paint uses sunlight to transform poisons in the air, particularly nitrogen oxide, into a harmless residue that is easily washed away by rain. The technology has proven effective in a series of European trials in Milan, London, and Paris. But NOx out has also been tested on a major metro rail station along the busiest highway in Metro Manila. Early results show that paint on the station and surrounding embankment is estimated to be taking out 1.3 metric tons of NOx per year. Taking the project further, Boysen, in cooperation with Metro Manila Development Authority, launched a project that will also improve the aesthetics along the major thoroughfares. Artworks of 10 renowned artists have started to dot the walls and flyover pillars of EDSA. Dubbed the EDSA Project, the year-long initiative was put up to help give commuters and motorists a refreshing contrast when they're stuck in traffic.
So how exactly does the pollution-busting paint work, and what are the other possibilities for its application? And here to discuss this with us is Johnson Ongking. He's the Vice President of Pacific Paint Philippines. Johnson, thanks very much for coming to Future Perfect.
Thank you, Tony. It's a pleasure.
All right. So it's been tested. I mean, NOx out paint has been tested in several places in Metro Manila.
Well, it's been tested actually in different parts of the world, not just
world.
Manila. All the technology in it. So
because Metro Manila is my concern, because if our pollution can be at least combated by this paint, then I guess in other cleaner countries, mas hindi siya mahirapan.
Yes, yes. And the biggest, actually, the biggest trial in the world for this technology was done in the Guadalupe MRT station. Yeah, EDSA, of course, because it's the busiest streets of Manila. The most cars, then you expect it's the one with the most pollution. Mm. So we did a test in 2009 together with the Manila Observatory, who's the country's leading air quality institute. Tsaka, Connexor, who's a Swedish environmental project management company.
Yeah.
So we monitored the air for 6 months before painting along the Guadalupe station, and then we monitored for the 6 months after we painted. And the results are very striking. Essentially, it can reduce, we've seen that it can reduce the NOx in the area by 20-25%, which is the equivalent of about 30,000 cars passing by the area every day. In that area, it's as if the 30,000 cars that pass by, all their pollution
had cleaner emissions.
Yeah, well, their emissions were cleaned by the paint, by NOx out. So
now this was tested worldwide, as you said, and I've read about buildings being painted with a similar application, because pollution takes a really heavy toll on structures, on buildings, you know, not just the corrosion, but also because, you know, it makes the buildings look ugly. I mean, they look dirty. Does it actually help prevent that?
Well, one really big benefit of NOx out, aside from the air cleaning, which is the main benefit, the side benefit is it's a self-cleaning paint. So the wall actually doesn't get dirty. Mm. And we see this in Guadalupe. And again, today's theme is solar power, but this is activated also by light energy from the sun on the outside. And on the places where the light is, it's exposed to sunlight in Guadalupe, it's actually really nice and clean, whereas everything else along EDSA turns from white to gray within 2 months, 3 months.
Yeah.
But if you pass by Guadalupe going southbound, the high wall on the side, it's still relatively white, and it's been 2 years.
Mm. And the paint is only, well, we know that there are particular kinds of paints for different kinds of materials, like for wood or concrete or even metal. The paint itself is just formulated to be applied on concrete surfaces?
Mostly on concrete, but it's... Yeah. It's easy. You can apply it on wood, on metal. If you just use the right primer for those surfaces, and then you can apply it. Going back to your earlier point, actually, the main consideration we had for NOxOut is really pollution is a bigger. It's a public health issue. Mm. That's the bigger danger of pollution. What it's doing to us, you know, it's doing harm to the buildings too. But the main problem is on us, especially children and because they're. More, they spend more time outdoors. They spend and they're active outdoors. Mm. They're the biggest victims of air pollution.
And the ironic thing here is that usually some of the safety advocates would actually warn about paint being very harmful to children, especially the time when there was still a lot of lead content in paint. Now, is this paint in a way? Well, of course, it should be non-toxic.
But
in a way, how safe is it? To be used?
Well, actually, it's beyond safe. I mean, it's completely safe from a user's perspective. Yeah. By the way, Boysen paints, we phased out lead
many years ago.
So it doesn't have any toxic materials, but it really changes the paradigm of paint. Now, it's anything you paint with NOxOut becomes an air purifier. Mm. So instead of just not causing harm, it's actually improving the environment. It's actively improving the environment, and that's a very big change. And what it really means is suddenly you and I, who the ordinary person who before could not just accept that air pollution, there's nothing you can do about it.
Sure,
the air is dirty. Now you can actually do something about it. Mm-hmm. You can just get NOxOut and paint a wall, and it'll help protect you.
And are there any property developers who have tried using these on their buildings, high-rise condominiums, even home developers?
Well, there's many talks with clients going, potential clients going, but I'd like to cite two in particular. One, abs-cbn, your parking lot down here, uses this product.
Okay.
And Shell, that was just before the segment before, they've committed to now to paint all their new stations with NOxOut. They painted their last two along EDSA, actually.
Yeah.
One of them in Quezon City. Mm-hmm. So we have an advocacy. We're part of an advocacy called One Wall, One World. And the idea is simple, that every one of us can help improve the air pollution situation by painting a wall. Because any of us who use a motor vehicle, whether it's a motorcycle, a car, a bus, all of those produce NOx.
Right.
And that NOx becomes smog, and it's causing harm to everyone. And so we're all part of the problem. But now with NOxOut, we're saying everyone can be part of the solution too.
All right. And the solution has an artistic implementation as well, because part of the project to introduce NOxOut was through artworks.
Yeah, we have this... we're sponsoring this project called NOxOut Project EDSA, and it's going to consist of 8 large-scale artworks.
These are murals?
Public art.
Public art.
This is a professionally curated, it's the first actually curated public art exhibit in the Philippines.
All right.
And what we're doing is use the beauty of art to call attention, in a way, to the ugly problem of air pollution.
Mm.
And this is a very unique mixture of art and science, so to speak. So, it's an urban renewal project. So when we go through EDSA, it's going to make everyone who uses EDSA will have something nice to look at. But more importantly, that's something nice to look at. That piece of artwork is cleaning the air.
Yeah, actually, I have a question about how long the paint retains its color. I mean, normally with ultraviolet light, paint fades out pretty fast, but how much resistant to UV is NOxOut?
It's a very good question. Actually, as I mentioned, this paint is powered by UV. The more
the more sunlight it gets, the more it
cleans the air.
Yeah.
And the process where it cleans the air, it's called photocatalysis. Mm. And it's a very technical thing, but if you just break down the words, photo means light, and catalyst is something that accelerates the speed of a process. So a catalyst does not get used up in the process.
Mm.
So the beauty of NOxOut is, as it exposes the light, it just keeps going and going, cleaning the air. Mm. As long as the paint's on the wall, it just keeps cleaning the air. Mm. No maintenance needed, just sunlight.
So there's no, like, say, a period wherein its efficacy wears out?
No, not at all. As long as there's sunlight, and here, all it needs to work is sunlight and humidity. And in Philippines, we have plenty of both.
And do you need to reapply the paint every now and then? I mean, how much for periodic maintenance do you need?
Well, normally paint on an exterior in the Philippines, because we have typhoons, harsh weather.
Yeah.
Normally 3 to 5 years is, but that's knoxide is the same as normal paint in that sense. There's no.
Okay. So how much more expensive is it than regular paint?
Yeah, it's a very good question, Tony. Everybody asks that. What I want first people to understand when we look at this is, first, you're buying an air purifier. You're not really buying a can of paint. It just happens to be in a can of paint. But what the benefit you get is it's clean the air. And currently, there's nothing in the market. There's nothing
similar
you and I can buy, paint or whatever,
yeah,
that can clean the air, that can make the air cleaner and safer for you to breathe. So. Mm. You know, I can show you the math that when you use knoxide for every peso that you spend, you can spend 1 peso to send a text message, or you can spend 1 peso that you spend on this technology can clean 90 cars every year that passes by your house, for example. And I think it's very, very inexpensive as an air purifier. And think of it that way, the paint is free. Mm.
Well, I haven't tried sleeping in our basement parking lot to see if I'm actually overwhelmed by noxious fumes, and I don't plan to do that anytime soon. But if you do say that we've actually used knoxide for our basement parking, then I guess that's pretty good. I mean, some people do actually, they leave their engines open because maybe they're still in the car and they're waiting for it to warm up. So it's going to cut down on the carbon monoxide.
Yeah, the nitrogen oxide specifically.
The nitrogen oxide. Yeah.
Which is a principal component of smog.
All right, and is the project going to continue, or is there another stage to the knoxout project in EDSA?
Yes, there's 8 different artworks that will be put up. The first one has been put up in San Lorenzo by Bogie Ruiz.
Mm-hmm.
We can expect 7 more coming up. The next one will be in the EDSA Ortigas area, done by Bibi and Coco, a pair of graphic artists.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll roll these out maybe every 2 months for us.
And you'll also have to show that, of course, these artworks are not just good to look at, but actually serve the purpose of breaking down pollution, so you'll take measurements.
Actually, I think we've done enough testing to prove that it does.
So it's
probably not necessary to do. I mean, we've done the math. Say, every 1,000 square meter artwork is really the equivalent of planting 1,000 trees.
Oh.
You know, in terms of cleaning nitrogen oxides.
Absorbing.
And converting them into harmless substances. So, you know, again, it's something anyone can do. And instead, most people think of when they want to do something green, they go plant a tree. And it's very good.
In Muntinlupa, no? Or the new Bilibid prison.
The problem with that is you have to go outside the city.
Yeah.
Whereas with knoxide, you're doing right in the city, and it's benefiting the people who live in the city.
All right, and that's the container right there beside you.
Yes, here it is.
Knoxide. So it's available also commercially for household homeowners, at least.
And the Philippines is the only country in the world where this is commercial available to the common people.
Okay.
To the